Hi, everybody. Rhys Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Big Ten boasts some of the most storied programs in the history of the sport, and the entire league rises because of it. Early season action in the Big Ten. That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Fred Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Still walking along State Street, we're at one of the oldest stadiums in college football, Camp Randall.
And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calorie. Enjoy everything.
We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. He'll take it from the two. Tackle made at the 28. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Left and tackled in a hurry.
Sometimes a play is not going to work for whatever reason. Doesn't mean you throw the play away. You just need to execute better next time.
Pass right, running back's got it. Tackle made at the 34.
That'll bring up 34.
Immediately tackled. Morton picks him up 2 yards with that catch. Brown awaits the snap. And he's tackled at the 44.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field.
Makes the catch, and look out. He gets hit out of bounds around the 44-yard line. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and the quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
Taken down at the 50-yard line.
That is a loss of six on the play. That'll make it second and long.
From midfield, second down.
Ready, 180, wide, 80.
Little handoff. He's at the 40. Makes it out to about the 40. He steps up. Got a man. Watch out here. Tackle at the 25-yard line.
Boy, when you can rely on your tight end to move the chains, you got a big-time advantage over any defense.
Stepping up. Quick throw out to the receiver. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
Great job by the quarterback. He had a slant called against zone coverage and threw it at the perfect time.
Good outside run there. Splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's a seven-play, 56-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the four-yard line. He's taken down at the 25. Wisconsin's in the driver's seat right now, but it's still early, Kirk.
Yep, very early in this game, but you got to love the feel for it as far as they're concerned. They came up with a stop, and then they get points, and right now they're out of the gate.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. He's taken down at the 38-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
He's tackled at about the 39-yard line. Now he's scrambling, and he's tackled right around the 42-yard line. They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. It's away. Short punt. So now the offense comes back out, hoping for the same success they had on their last drive.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
Diving for extra yardage. Nice job by the quarterback to tuck that one and run.
Nice job here. He's not the most athletic quarterback out there, but you can see that he makes up for it with his decision-making ability. Here he looks downfield, finds nobody open, and decides to take off with it and comes up with a solid game.
Pass complete and taken down immediately. So they go to the air and pick up six.
You get 6 yards, and that makes picking up a first down very reasonable.
Wisconsin is up by a touchdown. Throws it in a hurry. They'll bring him down right around the 46-yard line. Makes it to the 37. Quick out to his receiver, and they make the stop at about the 29-yard line. Makes it to the 21.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. After one quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. Wisconsin leads 7-0. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter.
Ready! Green 19!
They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield.
Loss of 3 yards on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 5.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Wisconsin is up a score.
Let's go, defense.
And he throws it away. It's 4th down, and they're going to try to go for it. He's under some heat. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. And down he goes at about the 21.
He just timed the snap count there and really made a nice play.
So it's 2nd and 13. Ball on the 21-yard line. Here's the throw to the fullback. Tackle made at the 26.
Call it again at 5 yards. That'll make it 3rd and 9.
Taken down around the 33-yard line. Williams will be the return man. Didn't get all of that one. With 1 quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Wisconsin up 7 points. Makes the first down catch. Tackled around the 39-yard line. Short over the middle. And they'll bring him down behind the line.
Loss of 1 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 11.
So we got man, man, man.
Quick pass, and he's right there to knock it away.
This is a well-prepared defense. They know where to be, and they know what their opponent likes to do. And they play tight coverage as well.
3rd down now, and they need to get it to the 29. Steps out of bounds around the 38-yard line. Randall gains 2 yards with a short completion. Out of bounds, the 21-yard line. Gains his way to the 13-yard line. Wisconsin is up 7. And he gets hit immediately. Fires quickly. Touchdown. Converts the extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Let's have a look at some scores from around the country. Several surprises today. The Miners' rushing attack can be difficult to stop, and they get into the end zone for a touchdown. Talley's knack for hitting the hole has been most beneficial as he's found the end zone. The Miners are on top 24-20.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Morton from the six. Tackle at the 32-yard line. Well, you know the offense would like to generate more than they did on their last possession. Looking to scramble now. He can't get away from the pressure.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. He steps out at the 41-yard line. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
Brown to punt. It's a short kick. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Wisconsin's been playing like a well-oiled machine in this first half. And, Kirk, are we going to see more of the same in the second?
Well, I think as long as they can maintain the proper frame of mind, I think they've got a great shot to be able to pull away and win this game decisively. But the challenge for them will be listening to their coaches at halftime and continuing to play with that same aggressive attitude that they played with in the first half.
There's a very impressive open field tackle. Taken down at about the 37-yard line. That brings him second and five. He lets it fly. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on the 37. Complete, and he's hit right away. Joseph's at the tackle at the 32-yard line. Fourth down. Right now, he wants to get this kick away and change field position. Punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Pressured and brought down.
That brings up second and 13.
So that sack sets him back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. And he hits him hard at the 28. Don't go anywhere, folks. It looks like we might have a pretty good game on our hands after all. Wisconsin's lead is 2 touchdowns.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find, Reese, these ball hawks on defense. They need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, trying to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
Williams deep to return.
Fielded at the 9. He's out to the 30. Gets out to about the 31. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Immediately tackled. Hand off, and he's met immediately.
That is a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
He heaves it deep. And got him. He's tackled around the 16-yard line. Rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
From the 16-yard line, 2nd down.
Let's go.
And he stopped behind the line.
I like how the defense got all up into that option to disrupt it. The offense looks a bit unsettled after losing that battle.
Complete touchdown.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
Yeah. gets the PAT. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
Let's take a look at some action in the Big 12. Let's take a look at this one again. And for UTEP, it's going the other way. A pick six. Take it to the house. UTEP out front, 38-27.
A three-touchdown difference here, Reese, 21-0. Joseph has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Morton takes it at the four. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
So the Badgers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Makes it out to about the 36.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
And he's tackled around the 46-yard line.
Gain of 10 on the play. First down.
He laterals. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That makes it second and six.
He fights forward to around midfield. They lose 3 yards there.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Williams is back to receive. It's away, short punt. He gets hit out of bounds at the 38-yard line. 6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Brought down at the 47.
That'll make it third and one.
Three down.
Mike 50. Ready. Red 68. Red 68.
He fires this one. Caught with room to work. He's all the way. Touchdown. TD pass number three.
He's been letting it fly today, and his receivers are making plays. That is a great touchdown.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a quick three-play, 62-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. They line up to kick this one away. And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. The Wildcats are just falling apart in this quarter. I mean, are there any positives you can even use to motivate the team right now?
Well, as bad as it looks and feels right now, there's still over a quarter of football to be played. You just got to forget about the mistakes, try to get a little bit of momentum created, and get confidence back in this quarterback being able to make plays for it.
He's on the run, and now the ball is loose. The defense falls on it.
A lot of guys in the defensive backfield are ball hawks, and the safety showed it there by pouncing on the football.
this offense just torched the defense through the air with a great passing attack on their last drive.
This offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receiver. Because, again, they put so much time in trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
That makes it second and 10. From the 21-yard line, second down. Wisconsin up big right now in this one. They make the stop at the five. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him the first down. That's just a nice play.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Play action. Now he's on the move. Caught end zone for the touchdown. And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
The extra point with a three-play 20-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Morton takes it from the six, and he's tackled at the 23.
Well, this defense has got to be proud of what they've been able to do in this football game so far. Love to see the goose eggs up there for this defense. And the way their offense is playing, this game is really shaping together for this team.
Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. So it's second and 10, all on their own 23. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked.
Boy, these kind of plays result in a lot of confidence from this defense and the defensive coordinator. I will not be surprised to see this defense continue to bring this kind of pressure against this offense.
Sack for a loss.
That's a loss of 5 yards. That makes it fourth and long.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Brown awaits the snap. Didn't get all of that one. Williams fields it at the 41, brought down at the 32. I'm sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
That's three down and one to go. Wisconsin's got a huge lead. Well, folks, we head into the fourth quarter, and this one is a blowout. Wisconsin up big. Throws a bullet over the middle, and he's hit immediately. It's third down. They're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. Caught, open field. Tackle made at the 10. A player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They come out in a goal line set. Throws it and oh, he dropped it.
Well, you hate to foreshadow and assume that that drop could come back to bite them, but if this offense is able to put the ball into the end zone after that drop pass, this game could be over.
And he stops short. It's fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. This is to add to an already impressive lead. It's up, and he got it. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Wisconsin's defense has been a force to be reckoned with, especially in this game.
Well, they have stepped up today. They just seem to be dialed into what this offense is trying to do. Good job against the run. They've been very physical. What I love is how relentless they run to the football.
The deficit is huge, but as a player, you never want to slow down your effort. Believe me, coaches notice the ones who aren't trying that hard. He might not be able to get the pass off. Pass right, running back's got it. He steps out right around the 32-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
Larry. Hey, watch that. Check right.
Kill. Throws complete. He's got space to work. The fake. Gets it. He's in space. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 50.
That brings him second and five.
Hey, watch that. Check Mike 54.
Passes left. Gets it out to the halfback. Out of bounds at the 35. What a throw for a big gain.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Just under three to go in regulation. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he's taken down at about the 29-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
Down he goes at the 21.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 21. Caught out in the open. They'll bring him down around the 14-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Cantrell picks up about 4 yards with a catch.
I think they were expecting a run on that play, Brad, and it allowed the quarterback to throw for just enough yards to get the first down.
Nearly intercepted.
That makes it second and ten.
from the 10-yard line. Second down. Quick strike, and he drops it.
You don't think these guys get aggressive when it counts? Terrific hit to prevent the score.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. Throws off balance, incomplete.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Just under 2 minutes in the game. I'm pretty sure they won't win it, but they haven't quit yet. And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
That's perfect timing between a quarterback and his wide receiver. He recognized the middle of the field was wide open, and I really thought the quarterback kind of looked the safety off to open that play up to the middle and then made the perfect throw for the touchdown.
And he tacks on the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Plenty of action going on in the top 10. A tight game, two relentless fighters exchanging blows. The Fighting Irish have the edge, 7-0. In another game, let's take a look at some scores around the country. The top teams roll. And for Rice, they put up the first points in this game. Rice leads it 7-0.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. And he's taken down at the 43-yard line. So the Badgers came out from the opening kick, and they just imposed their will in this game.
Just a complete effort. You can look at the numbers. You can see that the stats show the offense has put up the numbers. The defense has done their job. It's about as good as you could hope for.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. He's into the open field. He's taken down at the 25-yard line. From the 25-yard line, it's first down. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. We have less than a minute to go. Around the 17-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 38-7, Wisconsin. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.